Yeah, thank you for opening the camera so that I can take your face. Yeah, I can see some of the face or so exhausted, but it's okay. This is maybe the last session for today's subject, right? Yeah, I guarantee that you have read the two files that I have sent to you. The first one and the second I uploaded on your virtual class. So today I'm going to take some simple quiz. I consider it you've all read the material. So let me go first to Andriana Nurfitria. Please unmute your microphone and answer my question. Andriana, do you hear me?
Hello?
Yeah, okay. I can hear you clearly. Hello?
Pak, suara bapak kok pelan banget ya?
Really? Ini sudah bapak, jelas?
Suaranya jelas kok.
Andriana kali yang kurang jelas. Yang lain gimana? Do you hear my voice clearly?
Jelas banget kok, Pak.
Jelas banget.
And how about you, Andriana?
Agak patah, Pak.
Patah? Tapi goyangan saya nggak patah-patah. Andriana, do you hear my voice?
Sebenarnya, Pak. Aduh, gimana sih? Oke.
Okay. Ya. Meskipun terpatah-patah, yang penting jangan patah hati ya. Oke, okay, Andriana, what do you know about translation?
Translation is
wajahmu kenapa ditutup? Meaning? Ketika nama yang saya panggil, jangan malu-malu. Meskipun Anda di atas pohon, nggak apa-apa. That's okay, that's fine. Ya, Andriana, coba dijawab lagi. What is translation?
Translation is transfer meaning search language into target language.
Good, yeah, okay. Berarti sudah paham. What is the literal translation mean?
Literal translation. Aduh, mana sih?
Oke, kalau sudah aduh-aduh berarti masih bimbang dan ragu ya. Oke, saya buatkan dulu di sini nilainya. Thank you, Andriana. And I go to Ririn. Ririn Sri Aryanti, do you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yeah. In translation, we usually find the shortened text, SLT and TLT. What do they stand for?
Maaf, sir. Saya nggak baca materinya. Belum baca.
Baru ketahuan, yang tadi kelas sebelah juga ketahuan bahwasanya most 75% they didn't read the material. But it's okay, ini cara saya melihat bahwasanya kamu baca atau enggak materi dari saya. Saya skip dulu untuk Ririn. Thank you. And thank you, sir. I go to Fortunata. Fortune.
Pak.
Kamu di dalam rumah kenapa pakai kupluk, Neng? Nah, itu kan cantik banget kayak gitu, ya. Dengan rambutnya yang aduhai, mempesona. Fortunata, di dalam penerjemahan pasti kita selalu tidak jauh-jauh dari namanya linguistic. Oke, kalian sudah belajar juga mengenai introduction to linguistic atau bisa diterjemahkan ilmu pengantar ya. Oke, apa arti dari lexicography or lexical? Fortune?
Kurang tahu. Pak.
Kurang tahu? Ya. Ya, oke.
Okay. Ada yang mau join, sir?
Ah? Kenapa, Kalfani?
Ada yang mau join, sir?
Oh iya.
Ada yang mau join?
Terlalu lama orang ini di lobby ya. Kita masukkan dulu ya. Saya buka dulu pintunya. Oke. Okay. Ya. Mereka tadi ke Riches dulu kayaknya. Yang samping kampus. Oke. Okay. Let me go to Maya.
Yes, sir.
Maya ini kayaknya hobinya sama dengan saya, nongkrong di warkop ya. Mudah-mudahan dengan ngopi berarti pikiran kamu sudah fresh ya. Ya. Yeah. Aprilian, what do you know about lexicography or lexical or lexicon?
Lexical, wait, oh my God, where is it? Lexical? Sir, I'm sorry.
You didn't read it.
Yeah. I'm okay. Trying to find it, but I can't find it.
So I skip first, Miss Aprilian. Let me go to Calvian. Calvian.
Hi, sir.
Hi. How are you?
Doing great. How are you?
Right. I'm good. Actually, thank you for asking. Calvian, what is usually change in translation? Apa sih yang berubah biasanya ketika kita menerjemahkan teks itu?
Form, yes, sir.
Form.
Yep.
Good. Berarti kamu baca ya. Okay. In terms of form, usually in linguistics, we study about morpheme. What is morpheme, Alvian?
Morpheme, morpheme itu dalam bahasa Indonesia atau gimana nih, sir?
It's up to you. Okay. As long as you know.
Hi, mana jenisnya morpheme ya? Morpheme itu kayak smallest word. The smallest word that has meaning.
The smallest word that has meaning. Sebutkan satu contoh, ini pertanyaan terakhir.
Oke, contohnya ya.
What are you looking at?
Run, sir. Nothing. Run.
Run?
Yeah.
Okay, is it free morpheme or bound morpheme?
It's a free morpheme, I guess.
I'll try it. Calvian, congratulations. You know much about linguistic. Ya, berarti duniamu memang benar di sastra ya. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Ya, mudah-mudahan kamu lah yang nanti masuk ke bidang linguistik.
Amin, amin.
Emilia, thank you, Calvian.
Yes, sir.
Emilia.
Yes, sir.
Hi, Emil. How are you today?
Hi. Good.
Good. All right. Yeah. Emilia, in translation, we find also... okay, what do you know about the field of linguistics? I mean the branch of linguistics. What do we study in branch of linguistics? Because linguistics is very close to translation.
Maaf sir, belum baca. Baru saya buka page 1 tapi saya
ya jujur lebih like baik it. Ya. Jujur lebih baik. Dari sini kita belajar bahwasanya apa yang dosennya berikan dibaca. Ya, yeah. Who is this? Thank you, Emilia. Saya skip dulu. Nona Emilia. And I go to Siti Nurul Maida.
Yes, sir.
All right. Siti Nurul Maida, what is semantic in translation? What is semantic?
Sir, I'm sorry.
Oh, you haven't known about that?
I read a little bit, but I forgot.
Yes. Thank you, Siti. I skip first. I am going to call Sofia. Hi, Sofia Shadrina.
Yes, sir.
All right. Where are you now? In your house?
Yeah.
Okay. Okay, let me repeat my question. What do SLT, MTM, TLT stand for?
What I read, SLRLTL.
Yeah, that's the same.
First language. Receptor. SLRLTL.
Yeah.
Source language and receptor target language.
Okay. Yeah, that's the same. SLT, source language text. And TLT, target language text. Yeah. I'll try. And what do you know about semantic? I asked Siti just now. Karena di dalam penerjemahan kita pasti selalu menemukan namanya semantic. So what is semantics?
It's like structure, like
no.
By going.
Kalau structure nanti itu bahasan yang berbeda. But thank you. You've trying much, Sofia.
Yeah, I'm trying.
I do appreciate that. Jangan stres. Saya hanya membuat kalian sedikit shock therapy. Bahwasanya tidak semua dosen memberikan materi ditiduri materinya. Saya ingin kalian membaca apa yang saya berikan. Padahal saya sudah membuatnya indah untuk dibaca. Saya sudah capek mengutip dari buku. And then kalian hanya biarkan begitu saja. Seperti cinta yang bertepuk sebelah tangan ya. Tapi ini adalah pelajaran buat kalian. Thank you, Sofia. Yeah. And I go to Mr. Muhammad Halfani.
Sir.
Okay. I can see from your face that you are a smart boy. Please answer my question. What do you know about idiomatic translation, Halfani?
The idiomatic translation, I think it's a change of a form. No, it has a similar meaning in form, but it can be different. But I think it has similar structure to the target language. The source language to the target language.
It doesn't have let me tell you, it doesn't have similar structure. that's not called idiomatic translation if it has similar structure.
Well, of course the meanings are still the same, but yes, it sounds
the meaning natural. Is the same, but
it's natural to the target language from the source language.
Yeah, and of course the structure is changed, right?
Yeah, yes, sir.
Okay. Can you make an example for me?
In English, there's an expression called killing two birds with one stone. In Indonesia, ada yang kayak sekali menyelam sambil minum sambil menyelam.
Sekali menyelam?
Sambil minum.
Oke. Okay. Sekali menyelam, sekali minum. Iya, yeah, I got
mungkin
it.
Mungkin maksud Bapak adalah
sekali
menyelam, sambil menyelam mendayung. Sambil minum air.
Iya. Yeah.
Sekali mendayung 2-3 pulau terlewati.
Nah, iya. Yeah. Saya sudah nangkap maksud si Halvani sudah oke, cuman kalimat yang dia berikan tadi saya membayangkan sekali berenang, sekali minum air. Jadi kalau kita renang, cuman sekali minumnya. But it's okay, Albany. I got it. Cuman tadi merangkai katanya kamu yang kurang pas. Tapi Albany understands about idiomatic translation. Thank you, Muhammad Albany. And I go to Nazifa.
Yes, Mister.
Oke. Okay. Kalau Nazifa ini selalu semangat, Bin. Sampai malam belajar juga semangat dia. Nazifa, in translation, we usually find syntactic. Dan kita nggak jauh-jauh pasti akan mendapatkan namanya syntax. What is syntax? Mata kamu kok tidak melihat wajah saya?
Sorry, Mister.
Lupa.
Belum baca itu.
Iya, belum baca dan ilmu apa namanya pengantar linguistiknya juga sudah lupa ya. Oke. Okay. Jadi jangan nanti lupa ya, bahwasanya kalian itu anak sastra, jangan pernah melupakan hierarki dalam belajar bahasa. Apalagi nanti kamu mengambil ilmu linguistik ya, harus paham bagaimana seorang bayi itu belajar bahasa sampai dia memahami arti ya. Oke, nanti kita bahas sedikit untuk itu. Thank you, Nazifa. I ask you first your name. I go to Shahla Farah.
Yes, sir.
Are you here, Farah?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Okay. I listen to you. And what is the meaning of components or the components of meaning, Farah? Okay. Thank you, Salah. Padahal itu teksnya baru minggu lalu saya kasih. Enggak kamu baca ya?
Baca, tapi kurang paham, enggak paham.
Oh, iya. Padahal itu kan kosakatanya masih yang sederhana. Tapi nanti mungkin waktunya kamu kurang banyak untuk membacanya. Tapi yang penting kamu sudah baca salah. Saya hargai itu, tapi saya skip dulu untuk nilai kamu ya. Thank you, Salafara. Alfian Rizky, please. Can you hear me? Enak,
yes,
kalian, enak kalian belajar sambil rebahan ya. Itulah enaknya daring ini ya.
Gak ada meja lah.
So pain because of
gak apa-apa, yang penting otaknya jalan. Nanti ketiduran malah kamu. Alfian, in doing the translation, usually a translator finds cultural context. So what does it mean, cultural context in translation?
Maaf, sir, bisa diulang? Kurang jelas tadi, patah.
Oke, okay. Apanya yang patah?
Kata-katanya patah, bisa diulang?
Oke, okay. Kirain pinggangmu patah. Oke, okay, Alvia. In translation, we find cultural context. What is cultural context, in your opinion?
Apa ya? Lupa ingat lah.
Iya. Kayak judul lagu. Lupa ingat. Oke. Okay. Ya, kalau sudah A berarti masih menggantung di awang-awang ya, belum melekat di dalam otak. But thank you, Alfian. Artinya di sini kita belajar pentingnya membaca ya. Apalagi kalian anak sastra yang pernah melewatkan sehari pun membaca teks, mau teks apapun 3 lembar dalam sehari untuk memperkuat otot-otot otak kalian ya. Pecinta sastra itu biasanya panjang usia dan ingatannya kuat karena memang sastrawan itu tidak luput dari aktivitas membaca. Dan juga membaca hati dan suasana ya. Thank you, Alfian. I skip first.
Yes, sir.
Your name.
Sorry, sir.
I go to... Yeah, you don't have to say sorry. I go to Raymond. Hi, Ray.
Hey, sir.
How are you?
Other than that, having a muscle pain, I'm good.
Oh, right. Terlalu panjang jawabannya. But that's fine. Raymond.
At least you understand, sir.
Okay.
Yes,
Raymond, what do you know about literal translation if we compare to dynamic translation or idiomatic translation? What is the difference between literal and idiomatic translation?
Literal is basically just translated one word by word, like this sentence, like piece of cake. If you say translate piece of cake, it's like translate one by one. So piece of cake is actually potong kue.
Okay.
You do idiomatic translation of piece of cake, actually sounds like it's super easy. It's like a piece of cake. So okay. You can easily do it.
Yeah. So is it the structure is the structure still in the same form?
The structure, I don't think so, sir. Because the structure of literal meaning and idiomatic meaning is actually not the same, because literal structure is actually you need to translate one by one. One word by one word, but idiomatic ones you need to translate as whole. So that means if there is an idiomatic behind it, you need to translate it idiomatic.
Nah, ini yang disebut dengan smart boy, ya. Jadi dia menggunakan kata-kata sendiri untuk menjelaskan dan selalu menggunakan contoh. Nah, ini adalah contoh yang bagus. Thank you, Raymond. you give a good example to your friends. Nah, jadi di dalam dunia sastra, guys, jangan menerangkan itu pakai kata-kata yang ada di buku, tapi rephrase ya, menggunakan kata-kata sendiri yang artinya kita sudah paham, dan dengan menggunakan kata-kata sendiri dosennya memahami bahwasanya oh, ini anak memang sudah paham gitu. Nah, ini adalah contoh yang bagus. Thank you, Raymond. So
no problem at all, sir.
Yeah, I go to ini kok wajahnya. Oh iya, bergerak ya. Saya kirain foto, ternyata orangnya langsung. Katarina Rachel.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Katarina Rachel. I call you Rachel?
Yes, yeah, Rachel.
Okay. Yeah, Rachel. And in linguistics, we learn about lexicography or lexical. So what is lexical?
I'm really sorry, sir. I have not read the material.
Oh, you haven't read the PPT, the files.
Yeah.
Okay.
Sorry, sir.
But yeah, okay. You don't have to say sorry. Means that after this, please read all the material. Thank you, Rachel, for being honest. And I go to Angelica Vuan.
So,
Can I ask something related to your name?
Yeah.
What is the meaning of Vuan? Have you asked your parents?
Suaranya putus-putus.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. That's my connection. I have a bad connection, maybe. Apa sih arti Vuan itu di nama kamu? Karena it's very unique to me.
Yeah. Waktu itu pernah dikasih tahu mama, katanya Sabtu.
Sabtu?
Iya, Sabtu.
Oke, okay. Nanti tanya lagi. Sebagai anak sastra, biasanya melihat sebuah kata kita agak curious ya. Apalagi nama kita sendiri, you've been 17 or 18 years old, harusnya sudah paham nama kamu. Itu out of context ya, karena saya tertarik saja dengan nama Vuan tadi ya. Saya kirain kamu apa dari Belanda mungkin, keturunan orang Belanda. Angel, the same question. What do you know about syntax?
I don't know, sir, because I haven't read.
Okay, good. Thank you, Angelica, for being honest also. And I go to Anjana Rivlin. Sorry. Raymond, how many students are in your class?
I presume.
22? Oh, so...
This is definitely not all, sir.
Oh, I see. If you are 22,
there's only 15 in
on
here.
My list is 16, including me, so there are 15 students joining this class. Okay, let me read first the list of the name that I have here. Andriana Ririn Sri, Fortunata Maya Apriliana, Calvin, Emelia Siti Nurul, Shofia M. Halfani, Naziva Shahla Farah, Alfian Rizky, Raymond, Katarina Angelica. Is there any name that I haven't called yet? Ada nama yang belum saya panggil namanya? Okay. Tidak ada ya. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. So, ya, bisa saya pastikan berarti 85% wajah-wajah cantik nan rupawan dan ganteng di sini belum membaca materi dari saya. Ini adalah shock therapy buat kamu. Saya adalah seorang dosen atau pengajar yang memang kalau saya memberikan materi, bahwasanya materi itu sangat penting untuk kalian baca, karena materi itu masih berhubungan dengan teori penerjemahan. Alright, that's okay, karena mungkin kalian belajar dari sini bahwasanya each lecturer has their his own method in teaching, and this is the way I'm teaching you. While I'm giving you a file, please read it, and then maybe the next week I will give you a simple quiz related to the file that I gave the previous week. Thank you guys. Kita nggak berlama-lama hari ini karena ini hanya cara saya untuk melihat apakah 2S mahasiswa 2SA05 dan 6 ini care dengan materi yang sudah saya kasih, dan ternyata belum, ya, hasilnya belum. Tapi minggu depan akan saya kembali menanyakan satu persatu, tetapi dengan nama-nama yang tadi sudah bisa menjawab akan saya skip, ya. Tapi nama-nama yang tadi saya skip kembali akan saya, I will ask you next week about our topic. So before we end this meeting for today, if you have any question, please ask. Ini materi mata kuliah terakhir, ya? Is it? Raymond, yes. Can you answer my question?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Berarti sudah tenang.
I lost focus there. What? What's the question, sir? I lost focus there. Just one.
Why you didn't focus? You were staring at your girlfriend?
I thought about something family stuff. I mean, I lost my focus there. I thought something about my family stuff. It's about my fifth year of my grandmother's death. I mean... Yeah,
that's okay. I just wanted to ask just now about if you have any question, please ask.
Not at all, sir. But a statement maybe what you thought about we don't care about your material is wrong. Actually, we do care, but. We just didn't read it yet, sir. Okay. We do care, but we just didn't read it yet.
Yeah, thank you, sir, for your explanation. Maya, please.
Yeah, I do care, but I don't really know that you put the material on virtual class.
Yeah.
So, I'm so sorry for it.
I thought it's explained differently, but as we know, and I have been told by someone in SA06 too, that FICAS material is also included. So I just got that from one of my friends there.
But my question is to Raymond. So you didn't share the material to your friend, the second material that I have?
I do actually. Oh. But maybe they,
okay, so I mean you did
I did send them, but maybe I don't know, yeah. But maybe they just buried that down there.
Yeah, I got it. Yeah. Okay. Any other question? So that is not question, that was a statement. But I thank you for Maya and Raymond for clearing or stating your worth it statement, means that you care about your friends. Jadi ya, saya hanya melihat wajah-wajah kalian biar saya nggak lupa. We've been 2 weeks. We didn't have Zoom meeting, right? Okay, guys. Ada di sini yang temannya mungkin yang tidak datang ini alasannya mungkin dia chat ke kamu. What was the reason he or she didn't join this meeting today? Can you please?
Actually, two person just
who are they?
Ask me for your number. I don't know why, but maybe you probably got reason, sir.
Oh, so you gave 2%. My number.
Yeah, 2%. I gave your number to 2%.
Okay, that's okay. Maybe just share my number to all your classmates.
Yeah.
Maybe
yeah.
Someday they will they will chat me for something important. Just share my number. I have only one number. So itu nomor saya satu-satunya. So di situ semuanya ya. Yeah. Thank you guys for joining this today's meeting. So I thank you for all your attention. And as I told you just now, next week I'm going to ask you one by one for those the names that I skipped just now. Just read the material, and if you find any difficulties, you can chat me individually, or you can ask Raymond also, because Raymond is, in my opinion, Raymond has read all the material. Have you, Raymond?
Yes, sir.
Have you read all the material, the both files that I gave you?
I read almost all of them.
Oh, sorry.
I mean, the last one, I just yeah. skip it.
That was what I'm talking about. From your explanation just now means that I got that you've read the material. Because that's, I mean, the question that I gave you just now, Raymond, that was the most difficult question that all your classmates, your friends at 2SA06 just now, they even didn't know how to answer that. Yeah. But you did. It means that you read my files or my PPT. Okay, guys, that's the end of our meeting. Thank you so much. Give my best regard to your parents and your best friends. And I'll see you next week. Bye. Thank you.
Bye, sir. Have a nice day.
Have a nice day,
too. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.